Continuing our discussion of measurements of location and position, now we're going to start emphasizing or talking about measurements of position. We've been dealing with location. In the next couple of videos, we're going to look at quartiles and percentiles, but first in this one, we're going to concentrate specifically on quartiles. Now, measurements of position described where a specific data value, or they do describe where a specific data value resides relative to the other data. Relative to other data. Where am I relative to other data? Quartiles and percentiles are the ones we're going to be talking about, and in this video, specifically quartiles. Now, in order to make sense, we really need at least interval data. I've seen some people use ordinal data for it, and it, to me, it's kind of confusing. Clearly, nominal data, there's no way you could do something like this. Ordinal data, I question whether it really means anything. I don't think it's proper, but I've seen some people do it, and I wouldn't recommend it. I wouldn't recommend it at all, but it is possible to do, I suppose, with ordinal data. First of all, let's talk about quartiles and what the notation for it. Now, in English, we'll make reference to the first quartile. Now, the parameter will be theta, just like it was for the median, only we're going to subscript it with a 1, theta 1. The statistic is Q1, and it measures, I'm going to say, the position such that at most 25% of the data is below and at most 75% is above. The at most is actually kind of important. Whenever we talk about the first quartile, immediately the thought is 25% below, 75% above. And that's the way it's interpreted, and that's the way we think about it, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But in reality, depending on how much data you have, it's going to be somewhat rare that you're going to actually truly have 25%, exactly 25% below, and exactly 75% above. With discrete data, it's extremely rare that would happen. So, if I had 24.2% and 73.1%, something like that, that qualifies. That works. And the reason that can happen is, think about if I have four data values. If this is the smallest, this is the biggest. If I use this, if this turns out to be my first quartile, well, what do I have below? Well, exactly 25%, right? What do I have above? Well, 50%. What happened to the 75%? In order to get 75% above, I'd have to have a value in between. So that sort of situation could happen. What if I only had three data values? Well, the quartile is going to be in here somewhere, where I had 33% below and 66% above. So with small data values, or small number of data values, a small data set is what I'm trying to say, actually starts to wonder if it has much meaning at all to begin with to start doing quartiles with. You should have a reasonable data set in order for it to have any meaning. So that's why it's possible that you won't actually have, and probable, you won't actually have exactly 25% below, 75% above. Now the second quartile you already know and love and adore as the median. Technically, I guess you could say that's theta 2 and Q2, but we never write it that way because it's so popular as the median that we kind of ignore the Q2 and theta 2 notation. But the definition for the median would be the exact same thing, except the 25% and 75% would switch to no more than 50% below, no more than 50% above. And the last is the third quartile. And that's going to be theta 3 and Q3. And again, the measurement is the same thing, only rather than 25% below and 75% above, they switch. It's the third quartile, so there's going to be no more than 75% below, no more than 25% above. What this is effectively doing is it's breaking data up into quarters. 25% of the data would be here, which means this is Q1, if I'm talking about sample data. 25% here, collectively that's 50%, well that's the median. 25% here, collectively this is 75%, that's Q3, and the last 25% here. Again, this is always at most, although we immediately think exactly 25, 25, 25, 25, and like I said, there's nothing wrong with it, that's fine. But in reality, you need to keep in mind that the at most idea. Now, if I combine the quartiles, here they are, with the minimum value and the maximum value, that gives me what's known as the five-number summary. The five-number summary is kind of cool because we can use the five-number summary to create both a graph, which we will do a little bit later in the calculator, and it's a numerical display, a kind of a numerical representation of how your data is distributed. Let's take a look at that. The five-number summary we can use to create what's known as a box and whisker plot. Now, this is the data we used back when we did a histogram for the exam scores. I think we call it like Calc 1, Exam 2. If we look at this, the data, or the minimum value for this data, is 44. The first quartile is 72. The median is 84. The third quartile is 92, and the maximum is 99. Now, I'm sure you're asking where these values come from. Well, you know how to find the median 84 by hand if you needed to. Matter of fact, you know how to do it in the calculator because we looked at the calculator and said, here's the median. Well, I'm going to show you again in a moment, but if you go back to that previous video with the calculator where I showed you where the median was, we're right above it was Q1, right below it was Q3. The entire five-number summary, the minimum, Q1, the median, Q3, and the maximum, are on that same screen, which I'll repeat for you in a little bit with this particular one. Now, if I use this to make a box plot, I need to come up with a number line here. So I'm going to call this my number line. And I need to make this reasonably scaled, which may be a little bit tricky. So if I start this off at 40, I'm going to say this is 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, that's close enough for right now, 100. Okay, where's 44? Well, 44, the minimum is going to be right about here, roughly right there. Q1, 72, where's that going to be? That's going to be over here, somewhere in there. 84 is the median, that's going to be roughly there. Q3, the maximum is 90. I'm sorry, Q3 is 92, and the maximum is 99. Well, if I go up to Q1 and Q3 and make a little box, put in the median, and I'm going to come out here and make a little dot at the maximum and another one at the minimum, and I'm going to reach out with the whiskers all the way to it. There's my box plot. Whenever you do a box plot, immediately, pretend like the number scale, the number line is gone. Everybody recognizes that this is the minimum value. This is going to be Q1. This is the median. This is Q3. This is the maximum. Everybody knows that. As soon as they see a box plot, they know that. From this, we can actually see the shape of the distribution. It would be skewed left because I have 25% here, so if I did a histogram, it would be pretty high. 25% here, which would be almost as high, but it's just a little bit wider, or at least appears the way I drew it. This is clearly much wider, so 25% of the data would fall down lower on a histogram. This is much wider, so on a histogram, I'd have boxes that are much lower. So that would be a skewed left shape to it. It's always a good idea if you're going to do this, especially if you're going to have multiple data sets. Maybe this is something to do with a day class, and I want to compare it to a night class. I'd want to stack and put one right on top of the other, but properly with the appropriate scale. That way I can look at it and make comparisons that have some meaning to it. Okay, in the next video, what I'm going to do is take a look at percentiles, And then after that video, I'll do one that shows you how to use your calculator to find the quartiles, how to do a box plot, and how to do percentiles on your calculator. Now, keep in mind, I'll warn you ahead of time, percentiles, there's not a magic bullet in your calculator. There's not a button you can push and say, find the percentiles. You have to do it by hand, like I'm about to do in the next presentation, but the calculator can help you a little bit. Anyway, we'll get to that in just a minute.